Hi, folks. Well, here's a news flash. Jesus said, let me read it, because if I paraphrase it, people accuse me of not speaking the truth. Wars, WARS, and rumors, RUMS. Two books. Now, we've discussed this before, but we're going to discuss it again. Jesus said in Matthew 24, verse 6, "You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come." Doesn't that insinuate that the wars and the rumors of wars is not it? It says, "Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of birth pains." It's just the beginning. "Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of me." Why are they hated? Are they hated because they're religious? No. Are they hated because they're Christians? No. Are they hated because they are troublemakers? No. Shit disturbers? No. What's the word? Vocal. Is that why they're hated? Because they're standing on the street corner yelling they think this or they think that? No. They're hated because of Jesus. That's the only reason they're hated. Because of Jesus. "Be hated by all nations because of me." Jesus is talking. Not because of you. Not because of anything you've done. But because of him. "At that time, many will turn away from the faith." Wait a minute, you can't turn away from something you're not already in. "Many will turn away from the faith and hate each other." Wow, sounds like wormwood, doesn't it? Remember wormwood of Revelation? It's bitterness. You know, when you got such a hate on for something or someone that it turns bitter. Yeah, for something or someone. "Many false prophets will appear and deceive many." They're liars. They're false prophets. They're deceivers. It sure sounds appropriate, doesn't it? "Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold." What love? Love for their fellow man? No, their love for God. Their fellow man is not God. Man is not God, period. Jesus is not a man, period. They'll hate you because of Jesus. "And the love of many will grow cold." Remember the first church of Ephesus? Where they forget their first love? I'm not going to go over it again. If you don't understand what I'm talking about and you want to know what I'm talking about, go back and watch the video on Ephesus, the first church. But he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. Not until. Paul asked us. He said, do you not realize you are the temple of the of God? That we're being built into a spiritual house, offering spiritual gifts and spiritual sacrifices with a spiritual understanding of the Word of God that the world does not have, nor possess, nor can it figure it out. And yet we've got liars out there running their mouths. They're hilarious. They're absolutely hilarious. They run their mouths. Oh, they're going to build the third temple in Jerusalem. They've got the brick and stones all prepared. So how many temples does the Old Testament talk about? 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope. Just 3. Just 3. And we're one of them. So if 2 have already come and gone, a brick and stone, and the third house, the perfect house, is not of brick and stone, just as our Lord Jesus said. It's not of brick and stone. Then what's the third temple? I guess it's his body, isn't it? The body of Christ. The body of believers. So is there going to be a third brick and stone temple built in Jerusalem? Nope. And what about these people who are claiming to be prophets of God saying that, yeah, it is. They're liars. Not speaking from God at all. In fact, they're completely, 100% contradicting what the Word of God tells us. Don't you believe them? What do you do with this great apocalypse that's coming? I'm not belittling the apocalypse. I'm not belittling the end of days. The tribulation. But I would really call to question whether you people believe when Jesus said it's finished, that it is actually finished. I really question if people believe that. Isn't it funny how 2,000 years of people being born, living, finding Jesus, not finding Jesus, living in this religion or that religion, and dying, and the tribulation doesn't touch them? Oh, that's not for them. That's for people farther down the road. Well, that's interesting. Jesus said it would touch everyone. Oh, well, he's just talking about those that are alive. Really? No, that's not what he's talking about. When he says everyone, he means everyone. My grandparents, I'm going back 100 years. My grandparents lived in a time where the end of days was upon them. For them it was. The Millerites, were so convinced in the 18, I'm guessing, I may be wrong, you'll have to look it up, Millerites, 1840s, so convinced, they sold everything they had, they believed this lying prophet, who claimed that the end of the days, you know, that the end of time was coming on such and such a date, so they sold everything they had, they all went out on this prairie, they sat down on a little knoll and waited for the appearing of Jesus. Guess what? It didn't happen, and the Millerites today are the Seventh-day Adventists. My parents lived in a day where everyone said, it's the end of days. And for them it was. For them it was. They came out with social insurance numbers. It was the mark of the beast. There was just no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Social insurance numbers were the mark of the beast. There was a huge upheaval. The people who didn't want to have a social insurance number. Did we all take the mark? Social insurance number, social security number, same thing. Did we all take the mark back then? Because if we did, if you take the mark, you're condemned. There's no salvation after taking the mark of the beast. Read the book. They're condemned. Did we take the mark? No. Now in my generation, again, it's the end. Prepare yourself. Is the message wrong? No. But neither is it right. Prepare yourself to meet the Lord is correct. Under what circumstances, they haven't got a clue. Because every generation since Jesus came off that cross and rose from the dead, every single generation since that time has stood at Armageddon. Every single generation since that time has gone through the tribulation. It is appointed to every man to die once and then face God's judgment. But in the books of Peter, it says the judgment's already come. What's going on? Let me just read this to you again. Remember, there's no lie found in the Word of God. If you read something here and you read something there, and they contradict one another, is not God lying. It's you who don't understand what's being said. You're not interpreting something correctly. And what you're not interpreting correctly is causing that contradiction. Either we believe the Word of God or we don't. So listen to this. You will hear of wars and rumors of wars, but see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All these things are the beginnings of birth pains. Then you will be handed over to be persecuted and put to death. And you will be hated by all nations because of me. Jesus is talking. At that time, many will turn away from the faith and will betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and deceive many people. Because of the increase of wickedness, the love of most will grow cold. But he who stands firm to the end will be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. Okay. We believe it? Jesus also said, let me find it here now. Marrying. And giving. Matthew 24. No one knows about that day or hour, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. Now this is Jesus speaking. For in the days before the flood, people were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day Noah entered the ark. And they knew nothing about what would happen until the flood came and took them all away. That is how it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. Two men will be in the field. One will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding at the handmill. One will be taken and the other left. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day the Lord will come. But understand this. If the owner of the house had known at what time of night the thief was coming, he would have kept watch and would have not have let his house be broken into. So you also must be ready, because the Son of Man will come at an hour when you do not expect him. Who then is the faithful and wise servant whom the master has put in charge of the servants in his household to give them their food at the proper time? Who? It will be good for that servant whose master finds him doing so when he returns. Remember the parable of the talents? It ain't talking about money. The talents, I mean. It's talking about what God gives us, which is understanding. It's wisdom from God, the tree of life, not the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. I tell you the truth, he will put him in charge of all his possessions. But suppose that servant is wicked and says to himself, my master is staying away a long time. And he then begins to beat his fellow servants and to eat and drink with drunkards. I watch these prophets today on television and to me, they're just drunkards. That's all they are. It ain't talking about alcohol. They're drunkards. They take a sip of the Word of God, and another sip over there, and another sip, until they're absolutely drunk, out of their minds, with false ideas. They become completely demon-possessed. Oh, earthquakes in various places. Oh my goodness, look at this. We got more earthquakes today than we had yesterday. Look at the increase of earthquakes. But fine. There's a reason for that. The scriptures explains that. But this is not what it's talking about. When the earth quaked in the Old Testament, it was Israel that shook. When the foundations of the earth were moved in the Old Testament, it was Israel's foundations who were moved. It ain't talking about terra firma. So they're eating and drinking and giving in marriage right up to the day the flood comes, and nobody has a clue. Do you really think that we can scream and yell Armageddon till the hounds come home and think we're telling the truth? We say we believe the Bible. Okay, the Bible says in the book of Job and in the book of James that there's two sides to wisdom. It explains it in the book of Genesis, the two trees in the middle of the garden. You can't have two trees in the middle of the garden. Can you? Remember, God is perfect. He's precise. When he says middle, he's talking about the middle. You can't have two trees in the middle of the garden. Unless it's one tree with two sides to it. Two sides to wisdom. Satan offered the first wisdom, the knowledge of good and evil. Jesus offered the second, understanding that comes from God. I guess I've said enough. Don't let wormwood. Wormwood is bitterness. Don't let wormwood eat away at your faith. Our faith is the action of loving, putting into practice what we preach. Loving. Spreading the gospel, the good news. Jesus is Lord. The Messiah has come. Call upon his name and be saved. We don't point at sin anymore. Because the sacrifice for sin has been given. We point at Jesus now. Because without him, we stand condemned. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Bye for now.